Hi, this is Vi from scrapinmaniac, and today I got my second auto shipment from Crafter's Companion from a show on HSM sometime in November or December. I'm not sure which show it was, but this is my third auto shipment, or actually my second auto shipment, and it's the Love Blooms, and look how beautiful that is. And I'll show you, I'm going to emboss it so you can see it. This is called Flourishing Frame. And this one is Entwined Roses. So let's go ahead and emboss these. I just got them in. I haven't opened them yet. They've been sitting there before Valentine, because this was supposed to be used for Valentine's. And I didn't even open them up. So let's go ahead and open these up and let's emboss with them and see how it looks. These are 3D embossing folders, so you get some dimensions in your embossing image. So there are some areas that are more embossed than others. They're very thick card, very thick material. You can emboss leather with this. I haven't embossed leather yet, but I am planning to do like a little mini album, and I will use it to emboss leather and see how well it works. So let me go ahead and try this one. Actually, I should write the names of it. So let me start writing the names of these and I shall be back. So I went ahead and labeled all of these so that way we know what they are. So I really like the Love Blossom one of most of all of this. So I'm going to go ahead and use this. And my raised area, this is my devos, this is my raised area, so I want to put my cardstock, and I need to cut this cardstock a little smaller. Let's cut it 5 1/4. And that should work perfect. I'm using die cut with a view cardstock. And I usually don't like to emboss with die cut with a view. We're going to try it out using some wax paper. Let's see if that's going to help prevent the cracking. Die cut with a view is the worst paper there is for folding anything. I don't know what they do, but their paper is not the best. Okay, so I'm using my Evolution. I'm going to put it at number 6. Dial 6. I'm going to use my A plate and my Cuttlebug C plate. So my Cuttlebug A plate and C plate. And that's because the Evolution is too big. I just don't like using that really huge platform for when I'm just making something small. Go ahead and go back. Let's do it twice. I want to really get nice impression. I think I went all the way. So it dials at 6. I'm using an A plate, a B plate, and it really sticks down. So let's look at it. And see, it didn't really... I think I needed to do a little more in the center. See how the center didn't really raise as much? But it looks good, but it needed to work a little more in the center area. But that's Love Blossom. Let's go ahead and do another one. This time I'm gonna go maybe 8. I'm gonna dial it to 8. And it's a good idea when you get your setting just right to write it down so that way you can use it for future projects. So this is the Entwined Roses. Okay, hopefully we set it. Do it at 6. Let's try it again. Okay, so it's grabbed it. Go very slow. and go twice. Let's just peek and see. Nah, didn't really work at all. But you can see the embossing. So I have to work on the pressure on this. Okay, let's do the last one. A lot of times with these embossing folders is trial and error. So far, a lot of errors. Okay, so let's do this one. Let me go ahead and mist it. So maybe that's what we need to do. So I'm going to do a lightly mist. So lightly mist. I put it in number 8. Put this here. Use my C plate. Let's see if I have another disappointment. Oh, it's going through. It's number 8. Going real slow. And then I'm going to go backwards. Feed it through. And this is the flourishing frame. Oh yeah, that worked really well. So missed it. Number 8. A plate for Cuddlebug. And C plate from Cuddlebug. That really worked very nicely. And see right here, it works good. These embossing folders, I guess I should put it more centered, but that looks very nice. Let's go ahead and try the other ones again. I got some left over here, so let's just use these. Let me try at the setting of 8. So right now I have it at 8. I'm going to mist these a little bit. So let me mist it. Put it down. Put my cardstock down. Get my A plate, my C plate from Cuddlebug. Oops. Take this one out. And then run it through. Oop, I'm going too fast. You really want to go slow. And come back. A lot better. But still the center is not getting as detailed embossed as I would like it. But it's still nice. So that's Love Blossom. Let's try the other one. Let me put it a little, like 8.5. And we're going to use, what was that other? Entwined Roses. Let's use that one. And this time I'm going to center it right there. I'm going to center this right here and then feed it in. I might have to get the Gemini Junior because it is not, I know it will work better there. Oh yeah, that worked a little. It was 8.5. Oh, look how nice that came out. And, oh, actually it's about 8. That's what I'm using. So I hope you like this video. I really like these embossing folders. But if you really want good results, if you have the Gemini, it will work a lot better. But when you do have these type of machine, the Evolution is the second best machine to use with these folders. You can use a Cuddlebug, you can use your Sizzix, but you got to keep playing with the sandwich. And it may be a good idea to create samples and write down the recipe of your sandwich and what you did in order to get the same results each time. Because depending on your paper, depending on the sandwich, and let me show you. Let's do the same thing with a Crafter's Companion paper. So let me go ahead and grab one of those and we're gonna run it through. This is Crafter's Companion. I'm gonna mist it. Okay, I like this love blossom. It has that nice heart in the middle. I'm gonna put my paper in here. Okay, A plate, B plate, and I might want to dial it up to 7 because this cardstock is a lot thicker than the other one, which is die cut with a view. A plate, C plate. Let's run it through. It's good, but still this middle part, I don't know if it's maybe it is the plate, but I thought that middle part would be a lot more embossed, but look at it. It looks nice. And then you can emboss these with other color. And what you can do is you can take some paste. So let's go ahead and get some. I'll be back. So now I'm gonna use some rub-ons. But I'm gonna use some pan pastel. And let me show you why I decided to buy this pan pastel, the metallic, than buying these metallic rub. Because look at that, it's dry. And I haven't used this. Now you can still reactivate it with water, so I use it kind of for like watercolors. But look, all of them are dry. You can put a little bit, but they're dry. And it's really irritating. See, another one that's dry. Completely dry. And I haven't even used them. Completely dry. So with these, I won't have that issue. I can, you know, look how nice these are. And the beauty about these, you can erase. So, and I still have to kind of just learn how to do a light hand, just really lightly sand these. And I think I may want to do this one. And you still can use these. So let's say I'm going to take a tissue. Kind of go over it a little bit. You can still go over with this. Like I want these green. And let's go ahead and get some water. So you can reactivate it. See, it reactivates. and then lightly go over it. So don't throw them away when they get this dry. Don't throw them away because you can still use it with some water. Yeah. And then use a flat brush to paint on top of it. And I just, almost with a dry brush. And I used to throw them away, actually. I threw some away of these metallic rub because they dried out. Until I discovered that they react again with water. And now I'm going to use red for these roses. So just clean your brush off. Go with your red. Now, one thing you really have to make sure they're completely dry. Do not store them wet because they will get fungus. One time I did store one of these that was wet. See how that's kind of wet now? And it did create fungus. And see, you can just lightly go over it. Rinse your brush, almost dry. I'm going to go back in the green. Just put some more. And there. And then I'm just gonna go back with some more of this green. Let's see what other colors I have here. Ooh, look at that yellow. Let's try that yellow. Okay. Last thing I will do is I'll take my a cloth and just go over it like so, and there, it's pretty nice. I like that. So I hope you liked this video, and thank you for watching. Bye now.